Dear students, today I am explaining the next subtopic from the topic phase equilibrium, that is the solubility of partially miscible liquids. Then we have to see what is meant by partially miscible liquids with the help of PPTs and the further part with the help of PPT. Partially miscible liquids are nothing but the solutions that we have to see here. The solubility of partially miscible liquids, how it is affecting with the change in temperature. First of all, try to understand what is meant by solutions. Solutions is a homogeneous mixture of two or more than two substances on the molecular level. Solutions are of different types, as like gas in gas type, gas in liquid type, gas in solid type, liquid in liquid type, liquid in solid type, solid in liquid type, and so on. In this case, we have to see the solutions of liquid in liquid type. Means one solution is liquid, another solution is liquid, and that two solutions are mixed with each other. That type of solutions we have to share. For example, the two liquids, whenever completely miscible with each other, that is a one type. Solutions of liquid in liquid type, in this type of solutions, there are three subtypes. 1, 2, and 3. First type, liquids that are completely miscible, example is alcohol and water. Means whenever we are adding the alcohol in water and shaking vigorously and keeping it on a stable ground, after some time what happens? Alcohol and water is forming a homogeneous, uniform, a single phase system. Means they are completely miscible with each other. They does not forming the two separate layers. The second type is liquids that are partially miscible. Whenever we are adding ether and water with each other in equal proportions, after vigorous shaking, they form the two separate layers, no doubt. But in ether layer, some quantity of water is become soluble. At the same time, in the water layer, some part of ether or some quantity of ether is become soluble in water layer. Means in this case, ether and water are showing the partially miscibility with each other. What about the third type? Liquids that are completely immiscible. For example, benzene and water. Add benzene and water in equal proportions with each other. Shake vigorously and keep it on a stable ground for some time. After some time, it is observed that there is a formation of two separate layers, and that layers does not contain the composition of benzene in water or water in benzene. Means these two liquids are completely immiscible with each other. In this topic today, we have to see the regarding the detail about the partially miscible liquids. How the partially miscible liquids showing the changes with raise in temperature or decrease in temperature. In the partially miscible liquids, their partial miscibility of the two liquids with each other, that is affected by the change in temperature. Whenever temperature is increases, in the case first or type first, then what happens? The partial solubility or the partial miscibility of that two liquids increases, and these two partially miscible liquids become completely soluble with each other at a upper temperature than that of the ordinary temperature. That upper temperature at which the two partially miscible liquids become completely miscible, that temperature is called the upper critical solution temperature or upper consolute temperature, that is UCST. This case of this type of situation is observed in the phenol water system. Then lower critical solution temperature, that is LCST. Whenever the temperature is decreased than that of the ordinary temperature, then at the lower temperature also, in some system, the two partially miscible liquids become completely miscible and forming a single layer. That temperature at which the two partially miscible liquids showing the complete miscibility, that point of temperature is called the lower critical solution temperature or the lower consolute temperature. It is observed into the triethyl amine water system. Then the third case is also present, in which there are some systems as like the nicotine water system, in which these two partially miscible liquids shows the completely miscibility or complete, they become completely miscible with each other at a upper temperature than that of the ordinary temperature, at which that two partially miscible liquids become complete miscible with each other. Means it having a upper critical solution temperature. At the same time, in the same system, it is observed that from the ordinary temperature, whenever the temperature decreases, then once again the two partially miscible liquids, that is nicotine and water, become complete miscible with each other at the lower temperature also. The lower temperature at which the two partially miscible liquids, that is nicotine and water, for example, they become completely miscible, that point of temperature is called the lower critical solution temperature or lower consolute temperature. That is also observed in the nicotine water system. Means it is a third type in which upper as well as lower critical solution temperatures are observed. Then I am explaining this part in detail with the help of board. So see towards the board.
Now I am explaining solubility of partially miscible liquids in detail for the further understanding. For that purpose, first of all, you should have to know what is meant by solution. Solution means what? A solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances on a molecular level. What is meant by solution? Solution is a mixture of homogeneous mixture of two or more than two substances on a molecular level. That mixture of substances is called the solution. For example, take 50 ml of water, add to it sugar, 1 gram sugar. Whenever you are adding 1 gram of sugar, then what will happen? That sugar gets distributed in the water or that becomes soluble in the water. Means in this case there are two substances, one is sugar and another is water. Whenever two or more than two substances mix with each other on a molecular level, that mixture is called solution. Solutions are of different types: gas in gas, gas in liquid, gas in solid, liquid in liquid, solid in liquid, and so on. In this case, it is an example of solid in liquid. In this solution, a substance which is in a lesser quantity, that is called solute, and substance which is in a larger quantity, that is called a solvent. Once again, try to understand. Solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more than two substances on molecular level, and in which a substance in a, which is in a lesser quantity, that substance is called a solute, and substance which is in a larger quantity, that substance is called solvent. In this example, sugar is only 1 gram and water is 50 ml. Sugar is only 1 gram and hence it is a lesser quantity, that is called a solute. And 50 ml is a larger quantity, that is called a solvent. This is the solution. Solutions are of different types: gas in gas, gas in liquid, gas in solid, liquid in liquid, solid in solid, and so on. In this example, it is an example of solid in liquid type of solution. But in our study today, we have to see the solutions of liquid in liquid type. Liquid in liquid. Solutions of liquid in liquid. In this type, there are also subtypes. First type is liquids which are completely soluble. Completely soluble or miscible. Liquids which are completely miscible. Example: alcohol and water. These are the liquids which are forming the mixture which is a homogeneous one, which are miscible with each other completely and forming a homogeneous part. Second type, liquids which are partially miscible. Example: ether and water. These are the liquids which are partially soluble with each other. Third example, liquid in liquids are the third type of liquids which are completely immiscible. Completely immiscible liquids are, example, benzene and water. These are the solutions in which liquid in liquid type of solutions are present. Means solute is liquid, solvent is liquid, in that type of solutions or mixture, that mixtures are called the liquid in liquid type of solutions. Liquid in liquid type of solutions, liquid is solute and solvent is also liquid, and hence it is called a solution type, that is liquid in liquid. These are having the three types. First is the liquids which are completely miscible, for example alcohol and water. Whenever we are taking the alcohol and water in equal proportions and mixing with each other in a beaker vigorously, and on standing or keeping it on the stable ground after some time, it will form a homogeneous and uniform part, a single phase only. And hence we can say that type of liquids are completely miscible liquids. Second type, these are the liquids which are called the partially miscible liquids. Means what? These are the liquids which are taken in this way. 50 ml ether, 50 ml water are taken with each other in a beaker and shaken vigorously or mixed vigorously, then what will happen? Some part of water gets distributed into the ether layer, or some water becomes soluble in ether layer. At the same time, ether is also showing the solubility in water layer. Means up to certain extent or in a particular proportion at a given temperature, one liquid is showing some solubility in another liquid and another liquid showing the solubility in the first liquid. These two liquids are called the conjugate solutions or the conjugate pair of liquids. Means in this case, ether and water are showing the partial miscibility with each other, and hence such type of solutions are called the partially miscible liquids. Third example is the, take two liquids as like benzene and water, try to mix them with each other after vigorous shaking. On keeping that beaker on the stable ground, we could observe that benzene layer and water layers are completely separated from each other, and there is no any mixing or there is no any solubility of benzene in water or water in benzene. That type of liquid pairs is called completely immiscible liquid pair. Amongst of these three types, in this chapter we have to see in detail the partially miscible liquids and how the temperature is showing the effect on their partial miscibility with each other. That we have to see in detail. Solubility of partially miscible liquids. For example, take ether and water, 50 ml of ether and 50 ml of water. Whenever they are mixed with each other and that mixture is vigorously shaken, after some time, what will happen? Some part of water becomes soluble in the ether. At the same time, some ether goes into the water layer. Means at the given temperature, there is some solubility of the ether into water and water into ether. These two liquids are showing the partial miscibility with each other. In this topic, we have to see the how the solubility of the partially miscible liquids is affecting by the temperature. Composition on x-axis. Whenever these two liquids are taken in equal proportions and vigorously shaken, then they show the partial miscibility in a particular proportion at a given temperature. But whenever we are giving the temperature or providing the heating to the given solution, then what will happen? As it warms, as the temperature increases, the solubility of the partially miscible liquids increases. And at a particular temperature, that two partially miscible liquids becomes completely soluble or completely miscible with each other. That temperature is called the critical solution temperature. Critical solution temperature, that is CST or consolidate temperature, means the solubility of the partially miscible liquids is affected with the temperature. As the temperature increases, the solubility of ether in water and water in ether shows increasing, or solubility increases. And at a particular temperature, that both the two layers become completely miscible with each other. Point of temperature at which the two liquids are showing complete miscibility, that point of temperature is called the critical solution temperature or the consolute temperature. This temperature having also particular characteristics with respect to the different systems. In case of the phenol water system, there are three cases regarding this. For example, in phenol water system, phenol is denser, its density is more, hence here we are taking the phenol, 50 ml of phenol and 50 ml of the water. The density of phenol is more than that of the water. Water floats over the phenol and they are showing the mutual solubility with each other. But whenever we are providing the temperature, after increasing the temperature, their mutual solubility also increases. And at a particular temperature, that two liquids are showing the complete immiscibility, that temperature is called critical solution temperature. But this temperature is above the ordinary temperature, and hence it is also called the upper critical solution temperature, that is UCST. Means whenever the two partially miscible liquids become completely miscible at a upper temperature than that of the ordinary temperature, they showing the complete miscibility, forming a single layer. That point of temperature is called the upper critical solution temperature, UCST, or the upper consolidate temperature. In some cases or in some system, the two partially miscible liquids, as like the triethyl amine, and water, in that system the partial miscibility of the two liquids goes on increasing as temperature decreases. In this way, in case of the triethyl amine water system, in the triethyl amine water system, at ordinary temperature, that there are two layers of triethyl amine and water, but as the temperature decreases, what will happen? That two liquids, triethyl amine and water, they are merging with each other and forming a single layer. Means they become completely miscible with each other at a lower temperature than that of the ordinary temperature. The point of temperature at which the two partially miscible liquids shows the complete miscibility at the lower temperature than that of the ordinary temperature, that point of temperature is called the lower critical solution temperature. Lower critical solution temperature, LCST, or lower consolute temperature. Means in some cases the partial miscibility of that two liquids is increasing on decreasing the temperature. That is the another case. In the third case, nicotine water system. In the nicotine water system, upper consolidate temperature as well as lower consolidate temperature is observed in the same system. In this way, means nicotine and water at the ordinary temperature shows the two separate layers with the partial miscibility, but as the temperature increases, that two layers of the nicotine and water, they are merging with each other at a upper temperature than that of the ordinary temperature. Here is the ordinary temperature, and at upper temperature that two liquids are merging with each other and forming a single layer. Means they are showing the complete miscibility at the upper temperature. That temperature is called the upper critical solution temperature, or the upper consolidate temperature. In this system, if the temperature decreases below the ordinary temperature, once again that two immiscible or partially miscible liquids are showing the complete miscibility at the lower temperature. That temperature is also called the lower critical solution temperature, that is LCST, or the lower consolute temperature. These are the three types which we have studied here. That is the first type in which the system in which upper consolidated temperature is observed. Second, the systems in which the lower consolidated temperature is observed, and some systems in which, as like nicotine water system, in which upper as well as lower consolidated temperature is observed. This is regarding the solubility of the partially miscible liquids.